Welcome viewers to TV Box Top, the channel for the best reviews in TV boxes, mini PCs and accessories. Today I got my hands on a new mini PC from BMAX, and this is their latest model called the BMAX B3 Plus. This model runs on the Intel Jasper Lake N5095 processor on 8GB of DDR4 RAM and 256GB of storage. So in this review we take a look at its features, what you can do with it, and you'll get to decide whether this mini PC is right for you. So don't go anywhere, my full review is up next. So I'm back, and in the box contains the B3 Plus model itself, one HDMI cable, a 12 volts 3 amps DC power adapter, a mounting bracket and screws, and a user manual. So its body is made entirely of plastic with a detachable top cover to access its RAM modules and its SATA M.2 2242 SSD. For input-output peripherals, two is rare, has two HDMI display ports, two Ethernet LAN ports, and its DC power input jack. To the front has two USB 3.0 ports, one USB Type-C port, a headphone jack, a power button, and a reset button. To the side has two more USB 3.0 ports and a micro SD card reader. And to its base has lots of ventilation holes for its internal cooling fan. So the B3 Plus starts up for the first time like all Windows devices do, with a first startup wizard where you log in to your internet network and your Microsoft account. So once you have completed the first startup wizard, you have a fully activated Windows 11 operating system. Here in its basic system information shows that the processor is an Intel Celeron N5095 CPU with a 2.0 GHz base clock speed, and it can go up to 2.9 GHz boost. It has 8GB of DDR4 RAM, and it's a 64-bit operating system. Below here it shows the version of Windows 11 Pro. And under product key and activation, it shows that this Windows is activated. For a bit more in-depth information, the N5095 SoC has a total of 4 cores and 4 threads with a base frequency of 2.0 GHz and a burst frequency of 2.9 GHz. This particular model comes with 8GB of 2666 LPDDR4 RAM, but it can take up to 16GB via two memory channels. Its GPU is the Intel UHD graphics with a base frequency of 450 MHz and a burst frequency of 750 MHz. It has a maximum resolution of 4K 2160p at 60Hz with OpenGL version 4.5. For storage, its M.2 SSD is a Keston 256GB 2242 NGFF model. It has dual band 2.4 plus 5GHz Wi-Fi with Bluetooth support. So with these specs under Windows 11, you get 4K display up to 2160p resolution, and under display properties, it shows that it has a maximum refresh rate of 60Hz. It has HDR display with auto HDR capabilities. You have 360 degree screen rotation to portrait mode and landscape, and reverse portrait and landscape modes. You have the option to connect up to 4 displays duplicated or in extended mode, 2 via its HDMI ports, 1 via the USB Type-C display port, and a 4th you can connect wirelessly. You get dual band 2.4 GHz plus 5 GHz Wi-Fi connectivity and Bluetooth 4.0. When connected via HDMI to a surround sound audio system such as this 7.1 audio receiver, under audio settings, you get surround sound options such as Dolby Atmos, DTS:X, DTS HD Master Audio, Dolby Surround from Dolby Vision Videos, and Dolby True HD.
This is Dolby Atmos, the world's first object-based cinematic audio. with powerful moving audio that transcends from channels.
This is the left channel. Next, we have the center channel. Over here is the right channel.
For entertainment purposes, this mini PC has HDCP protection, and you just saw that it has surround sound audio. This means you can install official movie streaming apps such as Netflix, Disney Plus, Amazon Prime Video and others, and watch movies in HD 1080p resolution only with Dolby Atmos. You don't get 4K. For watching YouTube videos, you get up to 4K 2160p resolution. However, at 2160p, it tends to buffer a lot, so I recommend that you set it to 1440p at 60Hz, that will result in no issues. The playing of 4K HDR videos is also okay. However, I recommend that you use the VLC player, as the default Windows movie and TV player tends to stutter a lot when playing these videos.
Points as Atletico, but the head-to-head goal difference is what
for 3D gaming, when applied to high graphics games, its graphics rendering is not the best, so I recommend you stick to low graphics games. First, let's take a look at some benchmarks and where it places on my rankings chart. First, its RAM copy speed and its M.2 SSD read and write speeds. It has a RAM copy speed of 9087 MB per second. Its M.2 SSD has a read speed of 393 MB per second and a write speed of 433. Next, its Wi-Fi and Ethernet LAN speeds. Based on a network speed of 154 megabits per second, the 5 GHz band and the LAN port achieved 100% of the speed of my network, and the 2.4 GHz band achieved 60%. Next, it's Geekbench 5 CPU benchmark speeds, and it scored 642 single core and 1860 multi-core. In the 3DMark Gamers benchmark, it scored 199 in the TimeSpy test. In the PC version of the AnTuTu benchmark, it scored 182,677. And in the PC Mark 10 comprehensive benchmark, it scored 1,945. In this test, you also get your web browsing score and your video editing score, and these are now included on the chart. So the scores are in, and the new BMAX V3 Plus is at position number 9 in relation to its PC Mark 10 benchmark score. If you would like to view this chart, you can do so on my blog, where you can compare various benchmarks and features. You can also view its video and coupon links right here. See the link in the description below this video. In summary, the BMAX V3 Plus is a high-performance budget Windows mini PC designed for modern-day work and entertainment, and has most of the features needed for a great Windows 11 experience. What I like about this model is that it can perform all basic functions required by a standard PC, such as Microsoft applications, browsing the web, watching videos, playing games. It has HDCP protection, and it can play all surround sound audio formats. The areas to be concerned about are its video editing capabilities, as its hardware is not powerful enough to support smooth 4K video editing. And even though the product description says that it has SATA expandable storage and the connecting pins are there on the PCB, there is no SATA cable included. So friends, that concludes this review. The BMAX V3 Plus is currently being sold on Amazon below $200 with a $50 on-page coupon. See the link in the description below this video. Links in the description are my affiliate links, which means when you use them to view or purchase a product, you provide monetary support to this channel, which in turn opens up opportunities for me to acquire new products and sponsors for review. So thanks in advance for using my links. Don't forget to hit that thumbs up button below this video to show your support. If you want to follow my channel, then hit that subscribe button and ring the bell next to it to be notified when I release another mini PC or TV box video. I appreciate you taking the time to watch this video. Stay tuned and see you in the next one.